Welcome to Geotech Practical Problems. Index Properties and Soil Classification. Number 2, Atterberg Limits, Liquidity Index, and Activity. The presence of clay minerals in a fine-grained soil will allow it to be remolded in the presence of some moisture without crumbling. If a clay slurry is dried, the moisture content will gradually decrease, and the slurry will pass from a liquid state to a plastic state. With further drying, it will change to a semi-solid state, and finally to a solid state, as shown in this figure. In 1911, Albert Atterberg, a Swedish scientist, developed a method for describing the limit consistency of fine-grained soils on the basis of moisture content. These limits are the liquid limit, the plastic limit, and the shrinkage limit. The liquid limit is defined as the moisture content, in percent, at which the soil changes from a liquid state to a plastic state. The moisture contents, in percent, at which the soil changes from a plastic to a semi-solid state, and from a semi-solid to a solid state are defined as the plastic limit and the shrinkage limit, respectively. These limits are generally referred to as the Atterberg limits. The Atterberg limits of cohesive soil depend on several factors, such as the amount and type of clay minerals, and the type of adsorption. Liquid limit. The liquid limit of a soil is generally determined by the standard Cassegrain device. This device consists of a brass cup and a hard rubber base. The brass cup can be dropped onto the base by a cam operated by a crank. To perform the liquid limit test, one must place a soil paste in the cup. A groove is then cut at the center of the soil pat with the standard grooving tool. By using the crank-operated cam, the cup is lifted and dropped from a height of 10 mm. The moisture content, in percent, required to close a distance of 12.7 mm along the bottom of the groove after 25 blows is defined as the liquid limit. It is difficult to adjust the moisture content in the soil to meet the required 12.7 mm closure of the groove in the soil pad at 25 blows. Hence, at least three tests for the same soil are conducted at varying moisture contents, with the number of blows, N, required to achieve closure varying between 15 and 35. The moisture content of the soil, in percent, and the corresponding number of blows are plotted on semi-logarithmic graph paper. The relationship between moisture content and log N is approximated as a straight line. This line is referred to as the flow curve. The moisture content corresponding to N equals 25, determined from the flow curve, gives the liquid limit of the soil. Plastic limit. The plastic limit is defined as the moist content, in percent, at which the soil crumbles when rolled into threads of 3.2 mm diameter. The plastic limit is the lower limit of the plastic stage of soil. The plastic limit test is simple and is performed by repeated rolling of an ellipsoidal-sized soil mass by hand on a ground glass plate. The procedure for the plastic limit test is given by ASTM test designation D4318. The difference between the liquid limit, LL, and the plastic limit, PL, of a soil is defined as the plasticity index, PI. Plasticity index is an indicator of the range of moistures over which a soil remains in a plastic state. The PI is also an indicator of the amount of clay particles in the sample. The higher the clay particle content, the higher the PI and the greater the chance of problems related to shrink swell potential and compressibility. The LL and PI are also used to classify fine-grained soils. Typical values for the Atterberg limits for soils are shown in this table. The Atterberg limits depend on the type of predominant mineral in the soil. If montmorillonite is the predominant mineral, the liquid limit can exceed 100%. This is because the bond between the layers in montmorillonite is weak and large amounts of water can easily infiltrate the spaces between the layers. In the case of kaolinite, the layers are held relatively tightly, and water cannot easily infiltrate between the layers in comparison with montmorillonite. Therefore, you can expect the Atterberg limits for kaolinite to be, in general, much lower than those for either montmorillonite or illite. Liquidity index. The relative consistency of a cohesive soil can be defined by a ratio called the Liquidity Index, LI. It is defined as this equation, where WN is the natural moisture content. It can be seen from the equation that, if WN equals LL, then the Liquidity Index is equal to 1. Again, if WN equals PL, the Liquidity Index is equal to 0. Thus, for a natural soil deposit which is in a plastic state, i.e., LL larger than WN larger than PL, the value of the Liquidity Index varies between 1 and 0. A natural deposit with WN larger than LL will have a Liquidity Index greater than 1. In an undisturbed state, these soils may be stable. However, a sudden shock may transform them into a liquid state. Such soils are called sensitive clays. Activity. Skempton, in 1953, showed that for soils with a particular mineralogy, the plasticity index is linearly related to the amount of the clay fraction. He coined a term called activity, A, to describe the importance of the clay fractions on the plasticity index. The following equation is for activity. Please recall that the clay fraction is the amount of particles less than 2 micrometer. Activity is one of the factors used in identifying expansive or swelling soils. Typical values of activity are given in this table. Example. A fine-grained soil has a liquid limit of 300% and a plastic limit of 55%. The natural water content of the soil in the field is 80% and the clay content is 60%. A. Determine the plasticity index, the liquidity index, and the activity. B. What is the soil state in the field? C. What is the predominant mineral in this soil? D. If this soil were under a concrete slab used as a foundation for a building, and water were to seep into it from watering of a lawn, what would you expect to happen to the foundation? Solution. A. Calculate the plasticity index, liquidity index, and activity. Plasticity index equals 245%, liquidity index equals 0.1, activity equals 4.1. B. Determine the state of the soil in the field. Based on the previous table, LI table, the soil with LI equals 0.1 is at the low end of the plastic state. C. Determine predominant mineral. Based on previous table, activity table, the predominant mineral is montmorillonite, most likely, natrium montmorillonite. D. Determine the consequences of water seeping into the soil. Seepage from lawn watering will cause the soil to expand. Montmorillonite is an expansive soil. Because the water content in the montmorillonite will not increase uniformly under the foundation, the expansion will not be uniform. More expansion will occur at the edge of the slab, because the water content will be greater there. Consequently, the concrete foundation will curl upward at the edge and most likely crack. Construction on expansive soils requires special attention to water management issues such as drainage and landscape. Generally, plants and lawns should be at least 3 meters away from the edge of the foundation, and the land should be sculpted to drain water away from the foundation. A liquid limit test, conducted on a soil sample in the cup device, gave the following results. Two determinations for the plastic limit gave water contents of 20.3% and 20.8%. Determine, A. The liquid limit and plastic limit, B. The plasticity index, C. The liquidity index, if the natural water content is 27.4%, and D. The void ratio at the liquid limit, if GS 2.7. If the soil were to be loaded to failure, would you expect a brittle failure? Solution. To get the liquid limit, you must make a semi-logarithmic plot of water content versus number of blows. Use the data to make your plot, then extract the liquid limit, water content on the liquid state line corresponding to 25 blows. Plot the liquid state line for the liquid limit. The water content on the liquid state line corresponding to a terminal blow of 25 gives the liquid limit, LL, equals 36%. Two determinations of the plastic limit were made, and the differences in the results were small. So, use the average value of water content as the plastic limit. The plastic limit is 20.6%. The plasticity index is 15.4%. the liquidity index is 0.44. Void ratio at LL. Assume the soil is saturated at the liquid limit. For a saturated soil, void ratio equals natural water content times GS. Thus, the void ratio at LL is 0.97. Condition for brittle failure. Based on LI table above, brittle failure is not expected, as the soil is in a plastic state. This wraps up the Atterberg limits, liquidity index, and activity. Thank you for watching.